Hello friends, welcome my channel. Today's discussion is test of convergences. So friends, now I start to discuss Cauchy root test. Let summation an be a series of negative terms and let rho equals to limit upper limit n over an, then number one, if rho is less than one, then summation is convergence. And number two, if rho greater than one, then summation an is divergence. This is the Cauchy root test. So friends, we have learned already the Cauchy root test, and now whatever you have to learn, you have to learn that this value limit nth of the an equals to limit n tends to infinity an plus 1 divided by in Abel's theorem, if sequence an is monotone decreasing, the condition limit n tends to infinity n a n equals to 0 is a necessary condition for the convergence of positive series of the positive series. So friends, we have learned that Abel's theorem. Another factor that we have learned, Cauchy root test. We have learned Abel's theorem, friends, and another is Cauchy root test. At this rate, test is called D'Alembert ratio test. This ratio test is called D'Alembert ratio test. The convergence of the positive series, an, summation an, where n equals to, you have learned that this is a necessary conditions. This is not sufficient, means then the convergence sequence hold these conditions, but it is not sufficient, means if this condition hold, then it is not mean that it is convergent. So it is not sufficient convergent. And another factor is Cauchy means every convergent sequence hold these conditions. Every convergent sequence hold this condition. But if this condition hold, this is not mean that the sequence is convergent. Another is Cauchy condensation test. Cauchy Dehn session condensation test. Now the test is Cauchy condensation test. So friends, all are very very important. All tests are very very important. If high n greater than 0 for all positive integer, for all positive integers n, for all positive integer n, and then n, then sequence high n is monotone decreasing, then the two series summation n equals to 1 to infinity high n and summation n equals to 1 to infinity h to the power n into phi h to the power n are either both convergent or divergent. Now friends, we start Leibniz test. So friends, the Leibniz test of convergence for an alternating series. The alternating series converges if a the sequence an n is monotone decreasing and number b an tends to 0 as n tends to infinity Now, according to the n tends to infinity example, summation n equals to 1 to infinity minus 1 to the power n divided by n. As an tends to 0 and n tends to infinity and 1 by n an minus 1 to the power n is MD means monotone decreasing. So friends, it is it is convergent. But this convergence is called conditional convergent. Conditional convergent. Against absolute convergence, I have told that what is absolute convergent. Then absolute convergent is that summation n is convergent and summation mod of n is also convergent. Then the sequence n is absolute convergence. Now friends, I want to discuss number two is conditional convergent. Conditional convergent if summation n is convergent but summation mod of n is not convergent. So friends, we called this convergent is called conditional convergent. So friends, whatever we see, example, I have told already conditional convergent. Summation 1 minus 1 to the power n divided by n is conditional convergent. Why? Conditional convergent. Because summation 1 by n is not convergent, is divergent. So friends, sequence is in here, sequence n equals to minus 1 to the power n and mod of n is equal to 1 by n. So friends, this is my conditional convergent example. This is the conditional convergent is two kind. One is conditional, another is absolute convergent. So friends, we have learned an absolute convergent is absolute convergent example. Convergent example is summation 1 by n square. Summation 1 by n square. So friends, this is the total test. I want to solve one series test. The convergence and divergence of summation 1 by n to the power p. So friends, summation n to the power 1 by p, it is this type of series is called p test, p series. This is called p series. So friends, the solution. Now let's start solution. Let phi n is equal to 1 by n to the power p. The sequence 1 by n to the power p is m dot d monotone decreasing. Let small h be a positive, small a h be a positive integer greater than 1. One may take h is equal to maybe it may be taking h zero, then h to the power n high h to the power n high h to the power n equals to 1 by h to the power p minus 1 whole to the power n whole to the power n. When number a, when p greater than 1, then 1 by h to the power p minus 1 is positive and less than less than 1, that is summation n equals to 1 to infinity 1 by h to the power p minus 1 whole to the power n is a geometric series with common ratio 1 by h to the power p 1 by h to the power 1 by h to the power p minus 1 is a common ratio r. By Cauchy, friends, I have already discussed Cauchy condensation test. Cauchy condensation test, if summation high n is equal to summation 1 to the power 1 by n to the power p and h to the power n high h to the power n. N equals to summation 1 by h to the power p minus 1 whole to the power n will both converge or will diverge. But since summation 1 by h to the power p minus 1 whole to the power n is convergent, therefore, summation 1 by n to the power p is convergent. Why it is convergent? According to the geometric series, we know that if common ratio is less than 1, n to the power p is convergent when p greater than 1. So, friends, why? Because we know that geometrical series common ratio is greater than 1, then when common ratio is less than 1, then it is convergent. then the geometrical series is convergent. And here we see that when p greater than 1, then the geometrical ratio is also less than 1. So it is convergent. Number b, when p less than 1, summation 1 by h to the power p minus 1 whole to the power n is divergent geometric series, because common ratio is greater than 1. So friends, we have learned that when p less than 1, then it is divergence, and when p greater than 1, then it is convergent. Now I want to discuss that when number case C, case C, when P equals to 1, the given series is harmonic series, and we know that harmonic series is divergent. So p equals to 1, then it is also divergent series, and I get the result p test infinity by the Cauchy condensation test. The p series, the infinite series summation p equals n equals to 1 to infinity 1 by n to the power n into the power n into the power p equals to 1 by 1 to the power p plus 1 by 2 to the power p plus 1 by 3 to the power p plus 0 up to plus 1 by n to the power p. It is convergent. Number A, it is convergent when if p greater than 1, and number B, divergent when p less than equals to 1. Number 2 is geometric series. Next I discuss geometric series. Geometric series, the infinite geometric series series A plus AR plus AR square plus AR to the power n minus 1 plus ... and a less than 0. Number A, convergent if r less than 1. If minus 1 less than r less than 1, that is mod of r
less than 1. Number B, properly divergent divergent to plus infinity if r greater than equals to 1 and oscillates. Number C, it is oscillates finitely if r equals to minus 1 and oscillates infinitely if r less than minus 1. So friends, we understand, we know this oscillates finitely if r equals to minus 1 and oscillates infinitely if r less than minus 1. Now let's we solve one problem based on convergence. The series x plus 2 square into x square whole to the power 1 factorial plus 3 cube into x cube divided by 3 factorial by this is the 2 factorial and it is the 3 factorial plus dot plus n to the power n x to the power n divided by n factorial plus up to infinity. If a 0 less than x less than 1 by e, number b x greater than equals to 1 by e, number c if 2 by e less than x less than 3 by e, number d 3 by e less than x less than 4 by e. So friends, this problem is very beautiful problems, that's why I have chosen. If answer, now I am going to answer. If un be given series, then we have un is equal to n to the power n into x to the power n divided by n factorial and un plus 1 is equal to n plus 1 whole to the power n plus 1 into x to the power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 factorial. Now the D'Alembert ratio test. Now the ratio test. Limit n tends to infinity un plus 1 divided by un equals to n plus 1 limit
n plus 1 whole to the power n x to the power n plus 1 into n factorial divided by n plus 1 factorial and n to the power n and x to the power n. This is x to the power n. Now we see limit n to tends to infinity n plus 1 by n whole to the power n into x to the power equals to e x. According to this, then it is greater than 1 when e x greater than 1, then series is convergent. Series is convergent. Series is convergent. So EX greater than 1, that implies x greater than 1 by e. So 0 less than x less than 1 by e, it is convergent. This is my answer. Hence, my answer is, this is my answer. Thanks for watching, friends. I hope I can clear this concept, but real analysis we have to do a lot of practice. I will publish a lot of videos based on real analysis. I hope my video will be helpful for all students.